Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. So today I hope that you all are doing fine. So in this video we are going to discuss the questions of March Spotlight. So let's begin the current affairs. But before that, if I'm not clearly audible or if there is any problem, then you can just tell me, and if there is no problem, then I will begin with the session. Good morning, Soumya. So I hope that I'm clearly audible to you. So I'm moving ahead. So before moving ahead, I would like you guys to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification because this is going to help you stay connected with our channel. And you can also join this Telegram group of ours, and the link of this Telegram group is in description below. So let's begin the first question of the month of March. So March has okay, so I'm completely audible. I got it, guys. So since it has been time since the March has passed, the month of March has passed, and the current affairs of March are very relevant for your upcoming NABARD grade A and B examinations. So let's revise the current affairs in this video. The first question is, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare signed an MOU with the Central Silk Board under the Ministry of Textiles on a convergence model for the implementation of agroforestry in the silk sector under the ongoing submission on agroforestry scheme. The MOU aims to promote agroforestry in silk cultivation, promotion of silk production in India, increase the income of farmers, etc. When was the National Agroforestry Policy adopted? So guys, do you know the answer of this question? When was this National Agroforestry Policy adopted? Let me tell you, when India adopted this policy, India became the first country in the world to have a comprehensive policy on agroforestry that aims to increase forestry as well as agriculture, forestry through agriculture. Now tell me, when was this National Agroforestry Policy adopted? Very good, guys. It is 2014. In 2014, this policy was adopted. And remember that the recent news is that Ministry of Agriculture has signed this MOU with Central Silk Board to promote the silk sector, to promote agroforestry in the silk sector. So that is the current news. Where is India's first forest healing center located? Dehradun, Haridwar, Nainital, Ranikhet, Haldwani. Where is this center located? Uttarakhand is the state. The exact location, very good, is Rani Khet. Very good. So, the answer has been given by Soumya. Okay, good. National Silk Development Corporation has collaborated with Sahi Pay to promote digital enablement and financial inclusion in the country. The MOU aims to promote nano entrepreneurship amongst youth in the financial services sector. Also, the partnership aims to facilitate skilling of youth in digital financial services and provide them with an opportunity to explore self-employment for sustainable livelihood. Candidates will be provided access to free digital skilling on online entrepreneurship program through NSDC's eSkill India portal. Which institution has developed Sahi Pay platform? So you have different options. Tell me, Sahi Pay has been developed by which institution? Very good, Soumya. It is option B, Manipal Business Solutions, that has developed this platform. And remember the current news that this NSDC has collaborated with SahiPay platform to promote digital enablement and financial inclusion in the country and nano entrepreneurship among youth in the financial services sector. So these are the purposes of this MOU, and this MOU is important for your exam. Moving on to the next question. From the 1st March 2021, Lok Sabha TV and Rajya Sabha TV have been merged. Now, Sansad TV will be the sole banner under which the proceedings, functions and features of the parliament will be telecasted. The first CEO of Sansad TV will be Ravi Kapoor, former IAS officer. In order to actualize this merger, a committee was formed by Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla and Rajya Sabha Chairman Venkaiah Naidu in 2019 to recommend on the merger of these channels. Who heads this committee? So you have the options. You need to tell that who heads this committee that was formed by Lok Sabha Speaker and Rajya Sabha Chairman to recommend on the merger of Rajya Sabha TV and Lok Sabha TV. Very good, guys. Former chair of Prasar Bharati. Can you guys name the person? What is the name of that person? The name of the head of this committee. It is Surya Prakash. Where is the Bridge of Compassion located? This Bridge of Compassion, very good, Uttarakhand mein. And on which river it is located? This bridge is located on Rishi Ganga River in Uttarakhand. Recently, the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir has launched an application to empower auxiliary nursing midwives and frontline health workers in carrying out their day-to-day work efficiently and effectively. The app has been launched under the National Health Mission for identification and tracking of beneficiaries. The application allows ANMs, that is auxiliary nursing midwives, to enter and update records of beneficiaries on real-time basis. This will ensure prompt update of data as well as improve the data quality and accountability. The app also works in offline mode. Name the application. So this is the question. Which is the application? What is the name of the application? Paramparagat, Sashakt, Angan, Anmol, Swasth are in the options. Anmol, very good. Anmol is the right answer. Remember, Anmol application was launched. Which state has collaborated with Denmark to set up the Center of Excellence in Dairy Sector in the state? So this is directly related to the NABARD. NABARD's fields of operations, dairy se related hai this Center of Excellence. So which state has partnered with Denmark to establish this Center of Excellence in dairy sector? वेरी गुड गाइस, इट इज राजस्थान. गुड, इट इज राजस्थान दैट हैज पार्टनर्ड विद 10 मार्क. सुपर 75 स्कॉलरशिप स्कीम इज एन एजुकेशन स्कीम दैट एम्स टू सपोर्ट द एजुकेशन ऑफ मेरिटोरियस गर्ल्स फ्रॉम पुअर फैमिलीज इन अ यूनियन टेरिटरी. दिस इज इन लाइन विद दिस ईयर्स थीम ऑफ द कैंपेन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल वुमेन्स डे दैट इज चूज टू चैलेंज एंड टू सेलिब्रेट आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव इंडिया एट 75, विच यूटी हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस स्कीम सुपर 75 स्कॉलरशिप स्कीम. दिल्ली, पुडुचेरी, लद्दाख, चंडीगढ़, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. वेरी गुड, इट इज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. एब्सोल्यूटली राइट गाइज. वेयर इज इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पावर प्लांट इस्टेब्लिश्ड? सो बेसिकली दिस वॉज इस्टेब्लिश्ड बाय NTPC. वेयर इज इट इस्टेब्लिश्ड? द स्टेट इज तेलंगाना. गुड, रामागुंडम. गाइज, देर इज अ कन्फ्यूजन अमंग स्टूडेंट्स दैट वेदर दिस वन और द ओमकारेश्वर और द फ्लोटिंग सोलर पावर दैट इज बींग डेवलप्ड ऑन ओमकारेश्वर डैम विच इज ऑन नर्मदा रिवर इन मध्य प्रदेश. ठीक है, विच वन इज द बिगेस्ट, विच वन इज द लार्जेस्ट फ्लोटिंग सोलर पावर प्लांट ऑफ इंडिया? सो रिमेंबर दैट इट इज द बिगेस्ट सोलर पावर प्लांट and it is the largest. It would have a generation capacity of 600 megawatts. So it will become the world's largest floating solar power plant. So it is going to be the world's largest. Now this NTPC's, which has been established in Ramagundam in Telangana, it has the capacity of 100 megawatts. So it is the largest solar power plant of NTPC. ठीक है, that is one thing. And secondly, it is the biggest one that is established in India. And this Omkareshwar Dam, this solar power plant is expected to generate electricity by 2022 to 2023. So at present, it has not been completed. It has not been developed. It is going to be developed. And by 2022 2023 it will be completed. So these were the facts that you need to know regarding the solar power plant in India. So this reminds me to ask you that which country has recently inaugurated or operationalized the world's largest floating solar power plant at present, because I said operationalized. So which country operationalized this? Aviral, your question is very relevant here, but the thing is that everywhere in the news and the government itself has said this thing that this one is the biggest and this one is the largest. Actually, Omkareshwar Dam is the largest in every sense, be it the land, be it the area in which this solar power plant be developed, be it the generation capacity, be it the investment that is being put in this power plant. Everything is greater than this Ramagundam solar power plant. But it is just that everywhere, every source that I could find, I could just scrutinize, in every source it was mentioned that it is India's largest floating solar power plant that has been established in Ramagundam. So here what I have deferred is what I have deciphered is that this Ramagundam is the largest floating solar power plant of NTPC, and this Omkareshwar is going to become India's as well as world's largest solar power plant. Okay, there are certain things for which the explanation is not given by the government or by the official sources as well, so it was left on us that how do we decipher it. So I have deciphered it in this manner that it is NTPC's largest and it is still in the planning stage. So do remember this thing, that it is also in the planning stage. Basically, it is being developed. It has not been constructed fully. Okay, so I hope that to some extent I have quenched your thirst for answers. But I know that this is not the full-fledged and absolute answer. But sometimes in current affairs, you have to memorize things. So I would recommend you that you should memorize this as it is. Okay. But yes, if you talk about in other dynamics, then obviously this Omkareshwar Dam power plant, solar power plant, is the largest in every sense. Very good, guys. It is Singapore that has unveiled the largest floating solar power plant that is operational. Okay. South Korea is developing floating solar power plant of 2.1 gigawatts. Samago. Very good. Yes. Yes, Soumya, absolutely right. But this is, again, this is even in the planning stage. Matlab, iske liye to tender bhi pass nahi kiya gaya, but still, this is the information that you need to know. Absolutely right. Okay. Where is India's first transgender community desk established? So, in which police station basically is this first transgender community desk established? Very good. Gachibowli police station, and it is in Telangana. What is India's score in the UNCTAD's Business to Commerce e-commerce index 2020? India ka score kya hai is index mein? Guys, what is India's score? Let me tell you, India's overall rank was 71. Now tell me, what is the score of India? Out of 152 countries that were assessed. I guess you guys don't know the answer of this question. That's why it is taking time. And I think some of you are Googling it. So let me tell you, the right answer is option B, 57.1. Even if you don't know the answers, you can just mention it right away that I don't know the answer, or just you can skip the question as well. Because this session is not your final examination. This is just for your revision, guys. So this is the opportunity that is being provided to you all, wherein you can just revise your current affairs, revise the questions so that you can do well in your exams. Achha, aapko to pata hi hoga, phase 1 and phase 2 ki, phase 1 ki dates aa chuki hai NABARD ki. So this is the indication that you should start preparing really hard for the exam. Okay. So 57.1 Tekken Games, not 57. Exact score yaad rakho, please. Okay. Which country has topped this index? It is Switzerland. But guys, do remember that e-commerce is the nascent industry in India that is going to boom by 2024 to 2025. Okay. But that was all about this index. Now let's move on to this humongous question. The length of this question is very much in itself. Very good, Neetu Krishna. So Neetu Krishna has mentioned the other I would say unique points or other sites of Uttarakhand that is of use for your upcoming examination. For example, the Pollinator Park, which is India's first pollinator park, is in Haldwani, Uttarakhand. Then she has also mentioned about the forest healing center that we have already discussed in Ranikhet. Also, the moss garden and the lichen garden are present in Uttarakhand. So these are the India's first centers that are established in Uttarakhand. So these are important. Okay, now let's move on to the next question. The Heritage Foundation's Index of Economic Freedom is an annual guide published to measure the progress made in advancing economic freedom. The foundation believes that the ideals of economic freedom are strongly associated with healthier societies, cleaner environments, greater per capita wealth, health, human development, democracy, and poverty elimination. This year's index has achieved a big breakthrough by eliminating Hong Kong from its ranking for the first time ever. On the other hand, Singapore has continued to excel in this ranking for a second time in a row. Talking about India, the South Asian nation has been put in mid-range of the mostly unfree category with a score of 56.5. So, score of India has already been given. Which of the following is not a parameter of the Global Economic Freedom Index? So, here you have been asked the parameters of this index. So, quickly tell me which one is not a parameter of this Global Economic Freedom Index that is released by this Heritage Foundation. Okay, so I have got one answer from Aviral, Shilpa, Gaurav, Agricos. Everyone is going with size of government, which is not the correct answer, guys. It is digital inclusivity, which is the right answer. Digital inclusivity is not a parameter of this index. Can you tell me that what is India's rank in this index? Very good, Ayush. It is 121. The ranking of India is 121 out of how many countries? The total number of countries was 184. NABARD ki 2022 notification. The 2022 tak ka to you need to wait because it is believed that in the beginning of 2022 the notification will be released, but right now, we are not in a position to say anything about RBI's notification. But yes, if you are a serious aspirant, then I would recommend you that you should start preparation for the RBI Grade B examination, as you should know that you have descriptive papers in your phase 2. So descriptive though without conceptual knowledge and a deep understanding would not be cleared. If you don't have that much understanding of the subjects of ESI, management and finance, for your RBI grade B, then you would not be able to clear the exam. So just start working on it. Notification, though, as I told you, that we are not in a position to tell you about the notification. Yes, I am talking about RBI grade B. Okay, so first, pine needle electricity generation plant is also being developed in Uttarakhand. Moving on to the next question. Aster X is the space military exercise of which country? Aster X. France, Germany, UK, China, Russia. Quickly tell me, very good, it is the France. Which two countries have signed an MOU for setting up an international lunar research station on moon's surface and or on the moon's orbit? China and Russia, Denmark and Netherlands, UK and Japan, India and USA, US and Canada. So which two countries are yes, absolutely right, Soma. So which two countries have signed this MOU to set up this international lunar research station on moon? Quickly tell me. Yes, Soumya, that Asterix exercise was conducted to protect the space assets. Good. China and Russia are the right answers. Which bank has launched the Vikas Asha loan scheme for women? Again, guys, these kinds of questions which are related to banks are very important for any of the banking examination. So tell me which bank has launched this Vikas Asha scheme? Ujjivan hai, India Post Payment Bank, AU Small Finance Bank, Bandhan Bank, Karnataka Vikas Gramin Bank. So these are the banks in the options. Which one is the right answer? Very good. Karnataka Vikas Gramin Bank is the right answer. Which organization has launched Women with Wheels initiative? Loan amount is not very important if you are talking about any scheme or any loan scheme that has been launched by a bank. Theek hai? Whichever bank it is, be it your Bandhan Bank, be it your Small Finance Payment Bank, such kind of amounts are not important, because if you do the amounts as well, then it would be a vast ocean. You would not be able to remember everything. So whenever it comes to banks, the loan schemes and the schemes that the banks launch or any initiative that the banks launch, you need to know the basic purpose and the names of the banks as well as the initiative that has been launched by the bank. Amounts are not very important, so you can skip the amounts as well, but not for RBI, SEBI, NABARD, SBI, because SBI is the largest bank of India, PNB or any other major banks, I would say. Okay, SBI, PNB, SIDBI, these are the major banks. So you cannot ignore the initiatives and the amounts of the initiatives launched by these banks. Okay. Okay, so the answer here is, I think you don't know the answer of this question, guys, because it has been time, but you haven't answered the question. So let me tell you, it is PNB Housing Finance, Women with Wheels, in order to provide loans to women for having their own vehicle. Wheels here for vehicle. So providing them loans so that they can start vehicle. Gaurav, I will check the link. If there is no link, then I will provide you the link in the description only. So you need not to worry about it. Okay. Moving on to the next question. Who is the president of International Olympic Committee? Who is the president of this Olympic Committee? Quickly tell me. Very good. Thomas Bash. Can you tell me who is the president of Indian Olympic Association? Good. Yes, he belongs to Germany. Very good, Soumya. Good. Thomas Bash is the right answer. Indian Olympic Association's president. Who is the president of Indian Olympic Association? It is Narendra Batra, and he is also the president of International Hockey Federation, FIH. Okay. Moving on to the next question. From which country has India leased Heron unmanned aerial vehicles as part of its emergency procurement program? US, UK, Israel, France, Germany. वेरी गुड नारायण नरेंद्र बत्रा. इज़राइल. एब्सोल्युटली राइट. ऑप्शन सी इज द राइट आंसर. विच इज द फर्स्ट स्टेट इन इंडिया टू हैव अ जेंडर फोकस्ड बजट फॉर 2021 टू 2022? मध्य प्रदेश, तेलंगाना, महाराष्ट्र, आंध्र प्रदेश, छत्तीसगढ़. फर्स्ट जेंडर फोकस्ड बजट. गुड. इट इज आंध्र प्रदेश. एंड रिमेम्बर, दिशा एक्ट वॉज ऑल्सो लॉन्च्ड, और वी कैन से वॉज ऑल्सो ब्रॉट आउट बाय आंध्र प्रदेश ओनली टू प्रोटेक्ट वुमेन. वेयर इज इंडियाज फर्स्ट ऑपरेशनल प्लास्टिक पार्क लोकेटेड? द राइट आंसर इज पैरादीप इन ओडिशा. सो दिस इज द प्लेस वेयर इंडियाज फर्स्ट ऑपरेशनल प्लास्टिक पार्क इज लोकेटेड. सो डू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग. ओके. विच कंट्री डज इंडिया कंडक्ट डस्ट लिंक, अ जॉइंट मिली जॉइंट आर्मी एक्सरसाइज? उज्बेकिस्तान, रशिया, ओमान, इजराइल, यूएई. गुड. उज्बेकिस्तान इज द राइट आंसर. वेयर इज द मोंगला पोर्ट लोकेटेड? भूटान, नेपाल, इंडिया, बांग्लादेश, म्यांमार. मोंगला पोर्ट. वेरी गुड सौम्या त्रिवेदी. उज्बेकिस्तान कैपिटल इज तश्कंत एंड करेंसी इज सोम. सो शी हैज मेंशनड इट ऑल. गाइज, वेन एवर वी आर डूइंग एनी फॉरेन कंट्री, यू आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल टू कवर द कैपिटल एंड करेंसीज योर सेल्फ. ओके, बांग्लादेश इज द राइट आंसर, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. वी हब, इंडियाज फर्स्ट एंड ओनली स्टेट लेड इंक्यूबेटर टू फॉस्टर एंड प्रमोट वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप टू स्टार्टअप स्केल अप एंड एक्सेलरेट विद ग्लोबल मार्केट एक्सेस हैज पार्टनर्ड विद एन इंटरनेशनल गवर्नमेंट टू लॉन्च अपसर्च. इट इज अ प्री इंक्यूबेशन प्रोग्राम टू हेल्प वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स फ्रॉम अक्रॉस इंडिया. आफ्टर द साइनिंग ऑफ दिस अरेंजमेंट द कंट्री इन क्वेश्चन हैज बिकम द वी हब्स फर्स्ट इंटरनेशनल पार्टनर. आइडेंटिफाई द नेम ऑफ द कंट्री. सिंगापुर, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, जर्मनी, जापान एंड USA आर इन द ऑप्शंस. विच वन इज द राइट आंसर? अपसर्च हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय विच कंट्री इन पार्टनरशिप विथ दिस वी हब? Good, it is Australia. Option B, Australia is right. Now this upsurge has been launched to help entrepreneurs in India. Okay, so remember that this upsurge is for India. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following scheme of Ministry of Labour and Employment has been merged with Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana? Good, option C is the right answer. Employee State Insurance Scheme. In which country has India opened its first of its kind India Energy Office to enhance energy partnership between the two countries? Indonesia, Japan, Philippines, Singapore, Russia are in the options. India Energy Office has been opened in which country? Aman, the Spotlight magazine is catering to RBI, SEBI and NABARD. Okay, so all the questions are taken from the Spotlight magazine. So automatically these questions are relevant for your SEBI exam as well. But as I always say, in current affairs, past 6 months are the most important. So it depends upon the notification of SEBI. If it is released in July, also if the notification of SEBI is released in January 2022, then also the questions that we are discussing right now will become irrelevant, because these questions are from the month of March. Very good guys, it is Russia. In Moscow, this energy office has been established. With which country has India collaborated for the Lunar Polar Exploration, LUPEX is acronym, mission that aims to send a lander and a rover to the moon's south pole by 2024? Australia, France, Japan, USA, Russia. Good, it is Japan. Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution has launched the Mera Ration app to help migrant workers under government's One Nation, One Ration Card system. The app currently covers 32 states and union territories, but it will be soon expanded to other places as well. This app allows all Indian citizens to register themselves on the app to get food grains at subsidized rate. Also, the Mera Ration app allows users to check what they are entitled to, locate nearby ration shops, etc. It also supports biometric authentication The app is only on Android for now. The app is only available in English and Hindi at present, but it will soon start to support a total number of dash regional languages. 14, 22, 10, 16, 11, which one is the right answer? Yes. Good. 14 are the languages that will be covered under this Mera Rashan application. Which state has launched Mahasamruddhi Mahila Sashaktikaran scheme? Good. Yes, first green ATM is located in Gurugram. Good. It is Maharashtra. Maharashtra has launched this scheme for the empowerment of women, which is very obvious from the name itself. How many Indian cities are in the top 30 rankings of the world's most affected air polluted countries as per the IQ Air's World Air Quality Report 2020? 15, 22, 10, 5, 25. How many cities are there? Which belong to India. Thank you so much, Raj. If you liked the morning session, I hope that every one of you are seeing the morning tales regularly, because the questions that I take in the morning tales are current affairs and very relevant for your examination. So do not skip those sessions, guys. So moving on to this question, tell me the answer of this question. How many cities of India are in the top 30. Good. The right answer is 22. Which organization released the Connecting to Thrive Challenges and Opportunities of Transport Integration in Eastern South Asia report? UNCTAD, IMF, FICCI, PhD, CCI, World Bank. Good, it is World Bank. World Bank has launched this report. Which two countries are producing hydrogen from brown coal for the first time in the world? Japan, Australia, India, Sri Lanka, US, Singapore, Spain, Italy, UK, France. Very good. Japan and Australia. Remember, hydrogen also has color codes: brown, green, blue, gray. I have explained what are the meanings of all these color coded hydrogens. So can you tell me that which one of these hydrogens is the most eco-friendly? Is the most clean form of renewable energy? Quickly answer my question, guys. Which one of these hydrogens is the most eco-friendly or the most or the cleanest renewable source? Thank you. I have got answers from Gaurav and Soumya, but I'm waiting for other people to tell their answers and then I'm going to tell you the correct answer. Very good. It is green because it is generated from the renewable energy. So the input is the renewable energy, then the output, that is hydrogen, is also green. Green hydrogen is the right answer. Moving on to the next question, what is India's rank in the PwC's 24th annual Global CEO survey? Blue is not the cleanest form of hydrogen because blue hydrogen is made from the carbon capture. Carbon and the gas emissions that are emitted while producing the gray hydrogen. So gray hydrogen is produced by using the natural gas, and the carbon that is emitted by producing the gray hydrogen is used to produce the blue hydrogen. Therefore, it is semi clean, you can say, but not the cleanest source. Okay, the cleanest one is the green hydrogen. Now, what is India's rank in this CEO survey? Very good, guys. It is fifth. India's rank is fifth. US and China are at the top position in this CEO survey. So, US and China are the top destinations for the CEOs, and India is at the fifth position. And remember, it is released by this PwC firm. Moving on to the next question, who among the following has been appointed in the World Economic Forum's Young Global Leaders from India for his or contribution towards Live, Love, Laugh Foundation India? अच्छा, यहाँ तो सारे ही बिग पर्सनालिटीज हैं इन ऑप्शन. श्रीकांत बोला, दीपिका पादुकोण, श्रीवर खेरुका, गजल कालरा, हितेश वाधवा. द राइट आंसर इज दीपिका पादुकोण. सो दिस लिव लव लाफ फाउंडेशन इज ऑफ दीपिका पादुकोण. विच बैंक हैज लॉन्च्ड स्मार्टअप उन्नति, अंडर विच सीनियर वुमेन पर्सोनल ऑफ द बैंक विल ट्रेन वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स फॉर 1 ईयर टू हेल्प देम अचीव देयर गोल्स? द राइट आंसर हियर इज HDFC बैंक. विच बैंक हैज रिसेंटली लॉन्च्ड बैंकिंग सर्विसेज ऑन व्हाट्सएप अंडर इट्स दिल से ओपन फिलॉसफी? दिल से ओपन किस बैंक की फिलॉसफी है? गुड, द राइट आंसर हियर इज एक्सिस बैंक. BSC इन्वेस्टमेंट्स लिमिटेड a wholly owned subsidiary of BSE, has signed a joint venture agreement with Frontier Agriculture Platforms Private Limited for developing innovative solutions for the agriculture produce trading markets. As part of this joint venture, the Frontier Agriculture Platforms bought 10% equity stake in BSE Agricultural Markets Limited. This is an important question, guys. Tell me that which one is the right answer. How much percentage, how much stake has been bought by this FAPL in this BSE e-agriculture markets limited? Yes, 40% is the right answer. Absolutely right. 40% stake has been bought in this Beams platform. Guys, can you tell me the full form of this Beams? Now you would be thinking that ma'am has gone crazy because Beams full form is written above. Then why am I asking you? I am asking you this, the full form of this Beams, because this is related to Blue Flag certification. This has nothing to do with this BSE's agriculture market platform. Blue Flag certification. So tell me the full form of this Beams. Okay, so Rishabh has written Bachelor of Ayurveda Medicine and Surgery. This has nothing to do with the Blue Flag certification. Blue Flag certification is related to the beach. This is basically an international accolade that is given to the beaches who are the clean, who are the most clean. Yes, Blue Flag means the beach one. The one that is given to the beaches for being the cleanest beach. Very good. So Soumya has given the full form, Beach Environment and Aesthetic Management Services. Absolutely right. Moving on to the next question. Which bank has launched Garima Savings Account Initiative for its women customers to allow them to offer multiple customized benefits, including a maximum of 7% rate of interest on the saving account? So all the women who are listening to me right now, this is an opportunity for you guys. Girls, go and grab this opportunity. Garima saving account. So jokes apart, now tell that which bank has launched it. Yes, Raj, 8 Indian beaches have been given the Blue Flag certification. And this was the first time ever that India recommended the 8 beaches for the Blue Flag, and they all got the Blue Flag certification. Janalakshmi Small Finance Bank, AU Small Finance Bank, ESEF, Ujjivan Capital Small Finance are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Okay, so Ujjivan, very good. Ujjivan is the right answer. With which company has Bank of Baroda partnered for facilitating formal credit of 1.6 million aquaculture farmers? So facilitating formal credit to these many aquaculture farmers. Guys, the answer to this question is way more easier than you think. Very good. Aqua, aqua. Aqua here be, aqua here be. Aquaculture Farmers and Aqua Connect is the organization. The effort is in remembering the name of the bank. Bank of Baroda. Okay. Which bank has partnered with TRAIN, Trust for Retailers and Retail Associates of India, a non-profit engaged in training and placement of youth in e-commerce and retail sectors? DBS Bank India. Very good. Which of the following act was amended to increase the limit of FDI in insurance sector to 74%? So earlier limit was 49%. It has been increased to 74%. So which act has been amended to increase the FDI limit? Very good. It is 1938. Insurance Act of 1938 has been amended by this Insurance Amendment Bill of 2021. Where is the General Secretariat of Asia Pacific Rural and Agricultural Credit Association located? Guys, it is in Bangkok, Thailand. Option A is the right answer. Thailand mein, in Bangkok. Who has become the first Indian to be elected as chairperson of the advisory committee of UN Human Rights Council? Yes, Raj, absolutely right. G.R. Chintala, former chairman of NABARD, was appointed as the president of this. Not the president, vice president. The president belongs to Sri Lanka. Very good. Ajay Malhotra is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. Who has sworn in as the new CM of Uttarakhand? Uttarakhand, very good. Tirath Singh Rawat. Can you tell me the name of Nepal's Prime Minister? Uttarakhand and Nepal are the two adjoining nations, not the nations, are the two adjoining territories. So tell me. Yes, now it is Pushkar Singh Dhami in Uttarakhand. Nepal ka PM. who is Nepal's PM at present? Yes, Sher Bahadur Derba. उत्तराखंड पीएम इज पुष्कर सिंह धामी. एंड नेपाल्स पीएम इज शेर बहादुर देरबा. ठीक है, दीज टू नेम्स यू नीड टू नो. दिस तीरथ सिंह रावत वॉज द अर्लियर वन. इट वॉज अपॉइंटेड इन ही वॉज अपॉइंटेड इन मार्च एंड देन ही वॉज रिप्लेस्ड बाय पुष्कर सिंह धामी. हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द चेयरमैन ऑफ द पैनल ऑफ एक्सटर्नल ऑडिटर्स ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशंस फॉर द ईयर 2021. गुड, इट इज मुर्मू, गिरीश चंद्र मुर्मू. हु इज द चीफ स्टैटिस्टिशियन ऑफ इंडिया? गुड, जीपी सामंता एंड चीफ स्टैटिस्टिशियन रेफर्स टू द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स. ओके, सो द अदर वे अराउंड दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इज हु इज द सेक्रेटरी ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोग्राम इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. कैन यू गाइज टेल मी हु इज द प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर टू द गवर्नमेंट एट प्रेजेंट? प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर. Who is this person? Name the principal scientific advisor of India at present. यस, के विजय राघवन इज दी राइट आंसर. एब्सोल्यूटली राइट चौहान, सॉरी राज चौहान. राव इंद्रजीत इज दी मिनिस्टर ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स. ओके, के विजय राघवन. हु इज द हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्पेस इन इंडिया? डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ स्पेस ऑफ इंडिया, हु इज द हेड ऑफ दिस डिपार्टमेंट? के विजय राघवन इज द नेम ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर. गुड शिवन, सो गौरव यू हैव राइट आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन करेक्टली. इट इज के शिवन. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर द चीफ ऑफ ISRO is the head of this department of space. Which Indian was one of the winners among the top 20 winners of Global Women Excellence Award for 2020? इट्स तमिलिसाई सुंदरराजन, तेलंगानास गवर्नमेंट एंड सॉरी गवर्नर, तेलंगानास गवर्नर. शी इज द यंगेस्ट गवर्नर एट प्रेजेंट इन इंडिया. ठीक है, शी इज द यंगेस्ट गवर्नर, तमिलिसाई सुंदरराजन एंड द फर्स्ट फीमेल गवर्नर ऑफ तेलंगाना इज वेल. ओके, नाउ दिस ग्लोबल एक्सीलेंस Global Women of Excellence Award is given by US, and it also includes Kamala Harris, the Vice President of US. Who has won the BBC Indian Sports Women of the Year Award for 2020? If you don't know the answer of this question, let me give you a hint. The person is a chess player. Very good. So I guess you did not need my hint, but still I gave you. It is Koneru Hampi. She is a chess player and one of the top-notch chess players, women chess players in India. Who has won the Yonex Swiss Open 2020 in men's singles? Very good, Victor Axelsen. This is a badminton tournament. Remember this thing. Yonex tournaments are always related to badminton. Okay. And ATPs are always related to tennis. Who is the translator of the Frontier Gandhi, My Life and Struggle book in English? Very good, Soumya. The right answer is Imtiaz Ahmed Sahibzada. Now, on whose life is this book based? Or basically, it is the autobiography of which personality? Tell me the name of the personality. This is an autobiography. So, it is the autobiography of which personality? Very good, Raj. Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan. So this book is the autobiography of him. What is the total incentive given under the production linked incentive scheme for pharmaceutical sector? Good guys, every one of you are mentioning the answers right. It is Abdul Ghaffar Khan. Very good, Raj. Absolutely right. Now guys, tell me the answer of this question. Production linked incentive scheme for pharmaceutical sector. 15,000 crores. Absolutely right. In how many categories are the pharmaceutical products divided in the production linked incentive scheme for pharmaceutical sectors? 15,000 crore. Is the right answer, Soumya? Quickly tell me in how many categories the products are divided. Very good, Neetu Krishna. for food processing sector, the total outlay is 10,900 crores. The products are divided into three categories, group A, B and C, and all these categorizations have been done on the basis of the turnover or the capacity of the production. 8,000 nahi hai, it's the 15,000 crores. Good. Guys, PLI scheme has been launched for 13 sectors and there is a lot to memorize in the PLI scheme. So I would recommend you guys to make separate notes for the PLI scheme. I hope that you would be making notes for yourselves. So PLI scheme is relevant for both of your phases, phase 1 as well as phase 2. So in order to cover that scheme thoroughly, you can make your precise notes of the PLI schemes only of different sectors. Okay. Because this remains in the news every time we go to the magazine. If you see Spotlight magazine of the past 6 months, then you would come across PLI scheme for more than 4 or 5 times. So this is how it is important. Achha, recently, the central government has launched the production linked incentive scheme for IT sector to provide impetus to domestic value addition for IT hardware, which is expected to rise to 20-25% by 2025. The scheme will target 4 sectors, namely laptops, tablet, all-in-one PCs and servers. What is the base year for calculating the value of incremental sales under this scheme? Absolutely right, guys. The base year is 19-20. Amounts, categories, the target of the government, like how much production the government aims to increase in that particular sector. For example, if we are talking about the LED sector, so how much is the target of production, how much direct employment will be created from that scheme. Basically, these are the targets of that scheme. For example, if the schemes, PLI scheme for food processing says that we are going to generate 6.8 lakh direct and indirect employment through this scheme by 2027 to 2028. So that is the target. Then you need to memorize that target as well. Okay. PLI scheme, mein, there is nothing that you can leave out, because as I told you that not only it is relevant for your phase 1, but it is also very important for your phase 2. So you cannot leave out anything. That is the misfortune for all of the aspirants, as well as for teachers as well, because we have to keep everything in our mind as well as put it in the magazine for you guys. Okay, so PLI for Atmanirbhar Bharat. Yes, 19-20 is the year. Recently, FICCI Higher Education Summit was organized by FICCI in collaboration with Ministry of Education and Commerce and Industry to give a platform to experts for deliberations on expansion of the higher education in India. The theme of the summit was Higher Education 2030 Rise, Resilience, Innovation, Sustainability, Enterprise, which envisages the target for higher education by the year 2030, which edition of the summit took place recently in 2021. Guys, do mention your answer here, which edition of the summit was held recently. Okay, and I will be back in just 1 minute. Okay, so I see that you have mentioned your answers. Very good. 16th is the right answer. Hmm. Which of the following statement is correct about the City Innovation Exchange? It has been launched by the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. It aims to improve the calculation of socio-economic dimensions of census towns for the purpose of census 2021. It aims to create smart cities in accordance with the needs of children and women. It aims to connect innovators with the cities to resolve the pressing challenges of the latter. Over 500 startups, 100 smart cities, and more than 150 challenges statements and over 215 solutions are present on this platform at the time of its launch. So which statement is correct about the City Innovation Exchange? Which statement is correct? Very good. Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs has launched this. Correct statement batana hai guys. Which one is the correct statement? So as I see that none of you has given the correct answer here. The right answer is option D. This City Innovation Exchange has been launched by this Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs to connect innovators with the cities so that the pressing challenges of the cities can be resolved by the innovators. So this platform is going to help the city innovators and also the smart city mission to resolve the challenges of the cities. So D is the correct option. All the other statements are not correct in relation to this City Innovation Exchange. Where is the Lal Bahadur Shastri International Airport located? Good, it is Uttar Pradesh in Varanasi. Which of the following statement is incorrect about the State of Environment Report 2021? So guys, you can read the options and quickly tell me which one is the incorrect statement here. Let me read out the option D and E for you. India ranked 117 among 192 nations in terms of sustainable development and was now behind all South Indian nations except Pakistan. Out of the 88 major industrial clusters in India, Tarapur in Maharashtra emerged as the most polluted cluster. Very good. The option A is incorrect. So this is not an annual report of PwC. It is released by the Center of Science and Environment only. And apart from this statement, all the statements related to this report are correct. So now let's move on to the next question. Which of the following helicopter has been gifted to the Bangladesh Air Force by Indian Air Force on the occasion of 50th anniversary of 1971 war? So here the answer is option A. This Alaut 3 helicopter was given to Bangladesh by India. ISRO has launched Brazil's optical earth observation satellite Amazonia 1 belonging to Brazilian National Institute for Space Research and 18 co-passenger satellites from India. And the US base from India, there is 5 satellites out of these 18, and from US 13 satellites out of these 18. So on PSLV C-51 rocket from Satish Dhawan Space Center at Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh. Out of the 5 satellites of India, one was the Satish Dhawan SAT, which is a nano satellite intended to study the radiation level, space weather, and demonstrate long range communication technologies. Which company has developed this SDSAT, Satish Dhawan satellite? Very good. Space Kids India has developed this satellite. Which state has launched the Gharon Ki Pehchan Chhelik Naam program? Daughter's name is a home's identity. So this is the English translation of this statement or this phrase particularly. Space Kids India is the right answer. Very good, guys. It is Uttarakhand. Option A is the right answer. Haryana has launched Mukhya Mantri Antodaya Parivar Uthan Yojana to uplift 1 lakh families with low family income in the state. The scheme was launched on the occasion of 644th birth anniversary of Dash. Other schemes launched on this occasion are Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Awas Navinikaran Yojana, Sant Mahapurush Vichar Samman, and Prasar Yojana. So basically, on whose birth anniversary was this scheme as well as these schemes launched? Good. Guru Ravidas is the right answer. Mobile train radio communication system has been launched for the first time in Indian Railways. The system can reduce train accidents and prevent delays in trains. It works akin to air traffic control systems in aircrafts. It will ensure smooth communication between trains. The new system has already been installed in 90 out of 100 rakes running between Churchgate and Virar. In which state is the system launched by the Indian Railways? Maharashtra, Karnataka, Odisha, West Bengal, and Andhra Pradesh are the options. Which one is the right answer? Where is this Churchgate and Virar located? Good. Mumbai, Maharashtra is the right answer. Central Revenue Control Laboratory, New Delhi, under the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, has been recognized as a regional custom laboratory of World Customs Organization for Asia Pacific region. When was the World Custom Organization formed? This was formed in 1952. Next question. UK based Liberty Steel Group has signed MOU with two European companies, Polworth and SHS, to set up France's first hydrogen based steel making plant at Dunkirk in France. Liberty is owned by Indian origin metals tycoon Sanjeev Gupta. The Liberty Group is a part of which of the following companies? Option B is the right answer. GFG Alliance is the company. Madagascar President Andry inaugurated Babatron 2, an advanced digital cobalt therapy machine at the Joseph Ravohangi Hospital. This machine was gifted to the nation by India. Where is Madagascar located? Good, Indian Ocean is the right answer. Arctica M satellite has been recently launched to monitor the climate and environment in the Arctic region. Among other functions, the satellite will also be able to retransmit the distress signals from ships, aircraft or people in remote areas as part of the International COSPES SARSAT satellite based search and rescue program. Which country has launched this satellite? Arctica 1M satellite was launched by which country? Basically, this is the question for which this much paragraph has been written. Now tell me which country has launched this Arctica M satellite. Good, it is Russia. Russia ne launch kiya hai. Very good, Gaurav. How many people will be living with some degree of hearing loss by 2050 according to the first ever world report on hearing of WHO? Very good, 2.5 billion. Guys, recently United Nations adopted a resolution on vision, which aims to help 1.1 billion people that are suffering preventable eye diseases. Can you tell me by which year does the UN aim to help these 1.1 billion people under this UN resolution on vision? And remember, this was the first of its kind UN resolution on vision to help the people in low and middle income countries who are suffering due to preventable vision diseases. Very good, it is 2030 is the year to achieve the SDGs as well. 2021 to 2030 is the UN decade on action to achieve the sustainable development goals. So ye bhi dhyan rakhna, decade of action. Recently, Fino Payments Bank has entered into the second schedule of RBI Act 1934. This accords the nomenclature of a scheduled bank to Fino Payments Bank and allows leeway to the bank in following some financial parameters like participation in the liquidity adjustment facility window of RBI, among other things. The second schedule of the RBI Act has only two payment banks till now. Which of the following is the other payment bank mentioned in the second schedule? Very good, Soumya. So, I care for everyone is the motto, and total economic loss that is suffered due to the vision loss is $411 billion. Yes, Neetu, ecosystem restoration decade is also this decade. Yes, India Post Payment Bank is the right answer, and it is the only bank with 100% government-owned equity. Payment bank, remember. Which of the following is not a feature of the active health policy, industry's first health insurance policy launched by Aditya Birla Health Insurance Company Limited? Okay, so let me tell you, the answer here is option E. So basically, this active health policy was launched by this Aditya Birla Health Insurance Company, and remember that it is the first plan to cover unlimited homeopathy telemedicine as well. That's why it is written that it is India's industry's first health insurance policy that is covering homeopathy telemedicine as well. Now, it does not cover expenses under the National Digital Health Mission, so it has nothing to do with this National Digital Health Mission. So this is the incorrect statement about this active health policy. Which company has launched SME Insure Portal to bring 5 crore small and medium enterprises under the insurance category? Very good. Alliance Insurance is the right answer. Recently, RBI has released its report on currency and finance for 2020 to 2021 for reviewing the monetary policy framework. The report states that the inflation target of 4% with a plus and minus 2% tolerance band is appropriate for the next 5 years. This report also sheds some light on the relevance of flexible inflation targeting on price stability apart from justifying the inflation range for India. When was this FRIT framework operationalized by RBI? Yes, Urjit Patel Committee is the committee for SMEs. Very good, Nilesh Suryavanshi. 2016 is the right answer. Good. अगर इजी क्वेश्चंस होंगे अंकित तो सभी पास कर लेंगे ना. देन व्हाट वुड बी योर यूएसपी? हु हैज टेकन ओवर एज द प्रिंसिपल डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ प्रेस इंफॉर्मेशन ब्यूरो, पीआईबी? All of you would be acquainted with PIB because this is the one website that is pestering you all as well. ऑप्शन ए जयदीप भटनागर इज द राइट आंसर. व्हेन इज द नेशनल प्रोटीन डे ऑब्जर्व्ड? वेरी गुड गाइज, फेब्रवरी 27 इज द राइट आंसर. एब्सोल्यूटली राइट. एंड द थीम इज पावरिंग विद प्लांट प्रोटीन, सो रिमेंबर द थीम एज वेल. स्वच्छ सर्वेक्षण वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स इन 2016 विद ओनली 73 सिटीज एज अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव फ्रेमवर्क टू एनकरेज सिटीज टू इम्प्रूव द स्टेटस ऑफ अर्बन सैनिटेशन वाइल एनकरेजिंग लार्ज स्केल सिटीजन पार्टनरशिप. रिसेंटली श्री दुर्गा शंकर मिश्रा सेक्रेटरी ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स हैज लॉन्च्ड द फील्ड असेसमेंट ऑफ स्वच्छ सर्वेक्षण 2021. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी ऑफ द सर्वे? वेरी गुड. क्वालिटी काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया इज द इम्प्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी. रिसेंटली द ऑफिस ऑफ प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया लॉन्च द स्वच्छता सारथी फेलोशिप अंडर इट्स वेस्ट टू वेल्थ मिशन. द फेलोशिप एम्स टू रिकॉग्नाइज स्टूडेंट्स, कम्युनिटी सेल्फ हेल्प वर्कर्स एंड म्यूनिसिपल सैनिटरी वर्कर्स हु आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग सिग्निफिकेंटली टूवर्ड्स वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. इन हाउ मेनी कैटेगरीज हैज दिस फेलोशिप बीन डिवाइडेड? गुड. थ्री, विच स्टेट हैज लॉन्च स्वामी आत्मानंद गवर्नमेंट इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल स्कीम इन ऑर्डर टू इम्प्रूव द इंग्लिश स्पीकिंग एट द मीडियम स्कूल लेवल? द राइट आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन, छत्तीसगढ़, बिहार, मध्य प्रदेश, राजस्थान, उत्तर प्रदेश. द राइट आंसर इज छत्तीसगढ़. ऑप्शन ए इज द राइट आंसर. बट मेजोरिटी टाइम्स राज, यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड अबाउट द डेटा बेस्ड क्वेश्चन ओनली, पर्टिकुलरली इन योर फेज वन. रिसेंटली मर्चेंट डिजिटाइजेशन समिट 2021 टूवर्ड्स आत्मनिर्भर भारत was hosted by central government FICCI and Better Than Cash Alliance to find out ways for enhancing the digitization of merchants in India's northeastern and Himalayan regions and aspirational districts. At the summit, the government of India exuded confidence that the National Language Translation Mission can be used to disseminate digital payments information, privacy clauses and consent content in the local languages for trust and empowerment. How many countries are a member of the Better Than Cash Alliance? Okay, so Nilesh has given the right answer. It is 75. How much market size of the pharmaceutical industry does the government of India aim to achieve by 2030? This is a target, guys. This is important. The answer to this question, guys, quickly tell me. It's 130 billion. 130 billion is the right answer. India and Norway. Yes, there was someone who's saying the questions are deep. Guys, because RBI changed its pattern, therefore the questions were deep and lengthy as well in all of your sections of phase one. And phase two also saw some similar kind of questions. But yes, it was relatively easier than the phase one. Now, in NABARD grade A and B phase one, also you can expect this kind of depth in questions. So you need to prepare yourself accordingly. Samarth, that I will check better than Cash Alliance members, because it is possible that in the duration between March and August, two new members have been added into that alliance. Therefore, I need to check it, and then I will tell you that how many members are there in this better than Cash Alliance. I will confirm it. Okay. Okay. So I guess you already have read the answer, read the question, and now you are answering it. So the right answer of this question is option D, Lakshadweep and Puducherry. So I'm moving on to the next question. Which country hosted the meeting of the International Commission on Large Dams? Norway, Denmark, Netherlands, Germany, India. The right answer is India. India hosted this meeting. Which of the following application has been developed by Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disability to enable people with disabilities and even the elderly to register accessibility related problems in buildings, in modes of transport, or any infrastructure by uploading pictures on it? Divyang Sarathi, Abhyudaya, Viklang Sathi, Sugamya Bharat, Viklikrit, Sashaktikaran. गुड, सुगम्य भारत इज द राइट आंसर. रिसेंटली सेकेंड एडिशन ऑफ ग्लोबल बायो इंडिया 2021 वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज वर्चुअली बाय डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, सीआईआई, इन्वेस्ट इंडिया, बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इंडस्ट्री रिसर्च असिस्टेंस काउंसिल एंड एसोसिएशन ऑफ बायोटेक लेड एंटरप्राइज. What was the theme of the summit? Global Bio India Summit. Yes, transforming lives is the theme of this summit. India has signed an MOU with one of the below mentioned countries in the field of renewable energy cooperation. The MOU entails exchange and training of scientific and technical personnel, exchange of scientific and technological information and data, organization of workshops and seminars, transfer of equipment, know-how and technology, development of joint research and technological projects. Identify the country. So in renewable energy cooperation, this MOU has been signed. and all this information is just the extra information that is provided to increase the length of the question. So this is how you need to train your mind to study, to read the questions quickly and grasp the exact question in within seconds. Okay, good. It is France. Absolutely right. Central government is planning to replace the Technical Education Quality Improvement Program with Merit Project to improve the technical education in India. When was the TEQIP program launched? The right answer is 2002. Where will Asia's and India's first dolphin research center be developed? Dolphin Research Center. It will be in Patna University in Bihar. Good. In which exercise of UAE has Indian Air Force participated for the first time? So the right answer here is Desert Flag. Which state is collaborating with International Crop Research Institute for the semi-aerobics to strengthen management of natural resources for the benefit of states, particularly vulnerable tribal groups that are dependent on agriculture? The right answer to this question is Odisha. Absolutely right. NCAER released its second edition of Land Records and Services Index 2021. Which of the following state is the new entrant in the top 5 rankings of this index? So, whenever you are covering any index released by Indian organizations like Niti Aayog, Center for Science and Environment, or any other prominent organization of India, then you are supposed to cover every minute detail of that index. Guys, I think you have read the question wrongly or heard the question wrongly, because I'm not asking you who is the top ranked state. I'm asking you who is the first or who is the new entrant in the top 5 rankings. So the right answer here is West Bengal. Last time it was ranked 6th, but in this year's index in 2021, it was ranked 5th. So it is the new entrant in this top 5 ranking, and Madhya Pradesh is the top state. Please do read the questions carefully. So this is the last question of the day. Which cities have topped in the top cities in million plus category and top cities in less than million category, respectively, of the Ease of Living Index 2020? So this is also an index that has been released by Indian organization. I think Raj, you haven't studied Spotlight as well as you did not attend my sessions of Morning Tales that I took in the month of March. This is the revision session where I am discussing 100 questions. So I am not supposed to tell you all the details of each and every questions. Here you are supposed to cover the questions and this is for your revision, guys. Revision हम कब करते हैं? जब हम already cover कर चुके होते हैं. तो आई थिंक आपने कवर नहीं किया है तो आई वुड रिकमेंड यू गो डाउनलोड द स्पॉटलाइट मैगजीन एंड यू कैन जस्ट प्रिपेयर दी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम देयर. दैट वाज द पर्पस टू मेक द क्वेश्चन ट्रिकी एंड मेक यू फॉल फॉर इट. दैट इज द पर्पस फॉर मेक बिहाइंड मेकिंग द डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चंस एंड एग्जामिनर इज ऑल्सो गोइंग टू डू द सेम इन योर एग्जाम. सो इफ यू आर सीरियस अबाउट द एग्जामिनेशन देन यू शुड स्टार्ट प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर the exam very diligently. Right answer is option A, Bangalore and Shimla. So here this session ends. I hope that you have learned or this session helps you in memorizing some news back from the month of March. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this session. Do not forget to watch the part two of March Spotlight as well, because March, as I told you, that it is a huge gap of 2 to 3 months at least between March and August. So there is a point that there is a possibility that you might have forgotten some news. So if you want to remember them, if you want to revise them, then do come on Friday at 10 a.m. on our channel. Thank you so much, Soumya. I appreciate you all, ठीक है, all of your patience and your diligence for the examination. Gaurav, don't worry about the PDF link because I'm going to tell you, I'm going to provide you the link of the website in the comment section below. Okay, comment section में भी मिल जाएगा, description में भी मिल जाएगा. Don't worry about the PDF. If you have your own notes, Raj, then it is a very good thing. You can remember from the notes and revise it quickly. टेंथ तो बहुत ज्यादा हो गया, बट यस, 10th सितंबर तक यू नीड टू कवर द करंट अफेयर्स बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दिस थिंग. एग्जामिनर्स पिक अप द न्यूज एंड द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर वेरी लेटेस्ट. Either they pick up the latest or they pick up the very old question back from the month of back from 8 months or 12 months. So that is how the spectrum of examiner goes, the mind of examiner goes. Okay, thank you so much, guys. Now I am leaving you on your own. Prepare hard for the examination and I hope that you come prepared for the next session as well. Thank you so much.